we're going to finish up our look at the big business of sports agencies with sports agent Jason Belzer. And let's talk about kind of what Michael Levine said about how proud he was about building that dynasty with the Heat. LeBron James, Dwayne Wade, Chris Bosh. I imagine that's not uncommon in this day and age, right?
That's right. So one of the things that's come as a result of this roll-up is the fact that these agencies are beginning to, in a lot of ways, represent all aspects of the business, from the players on the court to the coaches to the general managers and even some of the teams. It's not unlike what they did in the movie world, where they started representing actors and then moved to the screenwriters and the directors and eventually the studios. And so a lot of these transactions that occur, the free agency deals that are going on during the year, are controlled by these agencies. They represent a player. They want to move a player to a big city like New York or Chicago or Los Angeles, and maybe they do a package deal where they'll bring in the coach or the general manager and they'll build a dynasty like CAA did with the Miami Heat.
They are the true power brokers.
Yeah.
Let me run a theory past you guys real quick, right? The stock market's flirting with new highs every day. Businesses are being valued very, very richly. We keep seeing sports teams get sold for higher and higher records. What about like CAA and WMEIMG, right? The buzz is they may want to go public, but kind of two different strategies to be able to maximize that valuation.
That's right. So from a valuation standpoint, both CAA, WMEIMG are really the two biggest agencies in the world. CAA focuses mostly on the representation of athletes. So they have athletes in all the big sports. WMEIMG has instead focused on the marketing, sponsorship, and event side. So WMEIMG recently brought up IMG College. They recently bought up UFC. And so they're beginning to roll up all of these event and television properties, essentially, to hopefully go IPO. CAA looking at trying to bring in as many athletes as they can, with the, probably the intention of going IPO soon as well.
Kind of reminds me of when you and I were Hollywood moguls, right? The way Hollywood did it back in the day is the same thing they did with their Hollywood and talent agencies, right? Sort of the same strategy. They were building up to be able to get integration on many different aspects in the film industry with the actors and with producing and so forth. Same thing now they're applying to sports.
That's right. I mean, you see it in other industries, like with Amazon, who started their own studio and is now doing their own things, winning Oscars. And who are they working with? They're working with CAA, who's providing them with all the talent. And so it's a cross-platform.
You know, it's almost, when I think about it, like the perfect pitch, right? In Hollywood, you can package a producer, a screenwriter, a couple actors, and say, we have this ready to go. Now in sports, it's basically the same thing, right?
That's right. I mean, if you're a franchise in desperate need of a turnaround, you go to CAA, who represents the top two or three free agents. I need a coach. I need the general manager. If you give me the players, I'll hire whoever you want me to hire to run the team.
You know, you and I are never too shy from promoting our Sports Money Index. CAA, you know, when we talk about the value of connections, everything you're connected to and what's the aggregate value of all those people and entities, CAA is the only sports agency in the top 25. I think they're like ranked four. It just shows you how powerful and valuable those connections are and tells you why it is they're able to drive their revenues so high.
There is literally no transaction that occurs in professional sports these days that doesn't have CAA's fingers on it.
It seems at some point, though, Jason, and see if this is fair to say, that there would be a conflict of interest, or there potentially could be if you're packaging these types of things up. Fair to say?
Absolutely. So you have a conflict of interest, let's say, if I am an agent that represents a coach and a player, because whose interest do I have in mind? Am I trying to get the most value from my player? Am I trying to get my coach a better player so he can win more games? And where do I draw the line? And then what happens if these companies go public, and all of a sudden now I'm trying to increase and create shareholder value at the cost of what's doing better for my client? So for instance, let's say you have a free agency situation and an earnings situation that lines up. I want to boost my quarterly earnings, so I'm going to make sure that one of my clients signs a big contract, or maybe a contract for a little bit less money than he could get somewhere else, but he gets it in before my quarterly earnings come out, so I get a boost.
Do we ever see situations where a agent will perhaps land a player with a certain team, perhaps a little bit under market value or under the maximum they can get. But then maybe that agency will take on another role these days, maybe even dealing with, let's say, stadium naming rights, or they'll get other business in.
Sure, sure. So CAA represents the Yankees. They represent Madison Square Garden from a sponsorship perspective. So what's to say that they don't bring in a player hypothetically for less than maybe they're worth, but on the back end, they may get some money back on the sponsorship.
Jason, one final question. In compiling all of this about the agents and the agencies, has it become easier to do, or because of these shifts, has it become more difficult to do?
It depends how much the agencies want to cooperate. And the reality is, I think that's an emblematic of the industry as a whole. Some agencies are more than willing to kind of give their information out. A lot of other agencies are very protective and they don't want to give any information. So we look at over 5,000 contracts in order to come up with these numbers. And aggregate, it's about $43 billion. And over 7,000 athletes are accounted for in the industry.
A lot of numbers.
Now
crunching.
You know why I don't do the list and Jason does it.
Now I know why you're crazy, and he might be getting there, but he's not there yet.